everyone, and welcome to Zoodesia! We are down in the staff lounge admiring the absolutely beautiful selection of fish behind us. I am really, really loving this fish tank. This so far is one of my absolute most favorite builds in the entire area. And we had our crab floating around. Oh, there he is. He has managed to get himself into the corner, so we might have to keep an eye on our little crab and help him out later. But we have a bazillion and a half fish still in here, and so I know that we can definitely get them swimming around the pond where we've got our ducks if we have the coral deep enough. Oh, that took a minute to spit out. Sorry about that. But I was also thinking, you know, it's been a very long time since we have bothered to look for any of the other fish who happen to inhabit this world, because there's a lot of mo creatures, small fish and fishies and medium fish and things like that. So it would be interesting if we can ever find more of those fish. Now that I think of it, we haven't seen them in a very long time. So we might have to adventure to new areas to discover fish. But if we do, I hope we have a fish net. Do we still have a fish net? Got a lot of stuff. No fish net though. But yes, today is going to be a little bit of an interesting day because we do have a few things I need to do, including repair our steel leaf armor. I'm getting really worried about how low it's starting to get on durability, and we've been fighting a lot more, kind of defending our honor when it comes to the really aggressive mobs. So I'm thinking that we'll have to repair our steel leaf armor today. But I also need to get a whole bunch of our safari nuts freed back up, because to repair a steel leaf armor, we go to Twilight Forest. And if we're gonna go to Twilight Forest, then I wanna have empty safari nuts. So actually, do I have a bunch of leather? Okay, let's pick the ore berries first. And that cow was up here again just a few minutes ago, eyeing this place up. I don't know what Professor Cowplant thinks he is doing other than risking his neck. In fact, let's grab our... We're going to do a lot of random stuff today. Let's go ahead and enchant a bunch of books again, because we are trying to snag some key enchantments. All right, we're going to come over here and put these away. These ore berries are going to go away. I'm so excited that we have our awesome pigmen roaming around in here. What an awesome day that was. But see, we've got like some mice and some snails and that enderman and like a couple big cats, tigers, that we're going to add to the tiger sanctuary. Yogi, who we'll release back into his enclosure for now. But we've got a lot of our reusable safari nuts, which are exceptionally hard to make, if I recall correctly. Let me double check. Yeah, we need ender pearls, and the only enderman we have ever found so far is right there inside of that safari net. So I just want to empty out our safari nets. To do that, we need some leather. Do we have leather? Where the heck am I keeping leather? Would that be like the wool knitting basket? No, I think it would be under, it wouldn't be, not saddles and animal supplies. What about candles, glass bottles, and more? No, but there's a fish net. Holy moly days. Fish net. There's one of the things I wanted to do. So now we've got a fish net. Wonderful. What about over here? It looks like we might have to go buy a bunch of leather. Oh no, we did buy a bunch of leather. Haha. Well, there we go. So there is our single-use safari net. We just need the slime and the string. Oh, that makes me happy, because now we can free up all these safari nuts so we can go to Twilight Forest for a little while. Have some adventuring fun. Let's come over here, and then we want this one, this one. All right, split this up. There we go. Whoops. Whoops. Dang it, guys. There we go. That's better. All right, put that in here. Then we can make quite a few of these, actually. We might just leave these safari nuts. Nice. Holy moly days. Nice, 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 nice. Well, look at that. That certainly helps things out. Let's see. So here's Yogi, who we just have to release for the sake of releasing. Let's eat these ore berries. Get these out of the way real fast. Just gain a whole bunch of levels. We're still working on enchanting so that I can try to combine the enchantments on some of the pickaxes. Calf managed to make... Ah, there we go. Yum, 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 yum. Calf managed to make me a pretty good start to a pretty fantastic pickaxe. In fact, he made this one. the fossil finder, which is the paleontology 3, and I think that's because he was able to combine it with the books that we found. So I want to do that. Can we combine that with actually I'm not sure how he did that. I'll have to ask him. But we're just enchanting books because, like, we have our efficiency and the archaeology, and if we could get a fortune 3, then this would be a perfect archaeology pick. Or if we could get a paleontology 3, then this would be a perfect, like, almost perfect pick, because I don't know, actually I guess one or the other is what we are needing. Decisions. Yeah, efficiency and paleontology 3. So having a fortune 3 is really what we're looking for. Glacier Quaker. Nice. We actually have a whole bunch of permafrost and fossils to go through. We might do that today as a treat to ourselves as well. But let's start by putting some of these mobs away. This is a hostile mob. Watch out. Uh-huh. Yeah, that was short-lived on his end. He didn't even know it hit him. All right, so he goes back in there. And then we've got some big cats. Empty safari net. Whoops, wrong bag. It's kind of maintenance stuff. I apologize, guys. It's just stuff we have to get out of the way so I can have my safari nuts back. All right, Yogi, you're going to go up in that corner. And then we're going to swap that out real fast. In you go, Tiger. We're not even giving him a chance to fuss about it. Then we're going to put you away. Put you down. Oh, fudge. I forgot to have it ready. Hi. Yep, in you go. At least they're not very hostile. Now this Enderman might be interesting. Oh, we got him! Yes! So he did not escape us. We still have him contained. These are the swimming mice that we actually are planning on making like a little exhibit for. They are the swimming mice that we caught outside of Calf and Lubot's Dinosaur Research Center. So let me swap. Yeah, there we go. Gotta get a little, I got too much stuff in my inventory again. Come here. Oh fudge, I forgot. The only way to catch the freaking mice is with the safari nut launcher. That's why we had it set up the way we did. Alright, come here, you. Uh-huh. Where'd you go? Is he on my head? Where'd it go? Did we catch him? Is he back in the net? Where did that mouse just go? We have a mouse loose! We have a mouse loose in the laboratory! Oh, there he is! Alright, we'll get him. That was much easier than trying to catch him for the first time. I can't believe I let a mouse loose in the laboratory. How embarrassing. All right, we'll put the mouse away. Let's get the other mouse. Let me put away the... why do I keep opening the wrong backpack? Sorry, guys. Where? Okay, got this ready. All right, mouse. Uh-huh. Ah, dang it, I picked him up. I don't want to pick you up. I'm going to get you with the safari net. I missed. I missed again! He's like, no, 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 no. Oh, I picked him up again. No, I don't want to pick you up by the tail. I can't leave you loose, running loose in the lab. That's bad hygiene. Get in. Get in the net. Okay, I think we got him. One of these caught that mouse. There he is. That's hilarious. We're just chasing after this mouse with a little gun. Like, get back in here. All right. Then let's see. Empty, 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 empty. There we go, put the reusable away. And then we've got, let's see, Yogi, Sunflower, who gets to keep her safari net, and then these snails for the snail races. Because they were three cool little snails that were just all chilling together. And we were like, you know what, let's catch those, because one day I want to host snail races with Calf and Lubot. And that'll be what those guys are for. So there we go! Oh, I feel so much better having access to these nets again. This villager is actually hurt, but we've got one last single use, so we'll pop him out. Come on in, my friend. That's a pretty cool trade you've got there, but he is pretty low on health, so we actually caught him because he was dying somehow, and we're going to take him to the clinic once we get the clinic up and running, and he will be able to repair himself in the clinic. Oh my gosh, it's so nice to have all of our safari nuts except for this raccoon. Raccoon, you're throwing me off, my friend. So let's get one more safari net that's single use, and we'll put the raccoon inside. That's a good review of, like, which of the things in the safari, like, net stasis chamber. We're going to leave this set up so it can just keep producing, too. Which of the animals in the safari net stasis chamber do you want to see come out next? That's actually really important because that'll help me decide what kind of exhibits we're going to work on next. And right now I'm thinking pandas. I'm really into the idea of getting our panda exhibit set up there. Look at our supplies. We have so much supplies. Oh my gosh, it's ridiculous. All right, so that chore is done for the day, my friends. We did it! Nightlock! Little scritch behind the ears, Nightlock. We did it! So now I'm going to go upstairs. Let's enchant ourselves a few books. There we go. Can probably get enough for 3 or 4 enchanted books. Let's go visit with Persephone. Saturday special, Saturday special. Often we end up doing some chores like this. Persephone, little scritch behind your ears. There you go. Oh, right down to basic tab. There you go. Good, happy kitty. All right, so now. All right, let's just see what we got here. Sharpness 3. That's something. That's definitely something. Let's eat all these berries. Helps us with getting lots of levels. Nom 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 nom. Nom 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 nom. I wonder what the best level for trying to get Fortune 3 is. Alright, we're just gonna keep going. Nom 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 nom. Filling my tummy on essence berries. I can't wait till I can have a bazillion million essence berry bushes. I have a lot of levels and then I drowned in my own fish tank one day. And I lost a bunch of them. Oh, we could only enchant 2 books. That's okay. Alright. Unbreaking 3 and Sharpness 3. So useful. Unbreaking actually might be a nice thing to have. So that's 2 Unbreaking 3s. We'll put them next to each other. The Sharpness 3 is a pretty cool one, so we'll actually keep it over here. But we're looking for Fortune 3, so hopefully we can get Fortune 3 before too much longer. Alright, put those away. Hello, kitties. I had a whole bunch of sugar cane in here for sugar. I didn't know that. I guess it's because I keep it more for books. And I'm trying to think, releasing Yogi. Gotta put these away in the plant sorting chamber. Yes, and then we've got a bunch of gold coins. Oh yeah, and this chicken. I'm trying to remember what I was gonna do with all of this because we were gonna head over to the meadow of horses, my kitty kitties. Maybe. Yeah, actually we have to head over there anyway because that's where I wanna set up the twilight portal. That's where I wanna do it. Oh, I don't remember how to set up a twilight portal. So we'll have to go check on all those things. Okay, so first things first, Lily and Tate, you stay right there for a minute. We're just going to work through the night. And then I'm going to pop over here. And we're going to put these plants away before we head over there. Because I think it'd be fun to pop into Twilight Forest and do a little bit of adventuring over there for a while. Oh, actually, these are a bunch of good plants. No, 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 no. Can't have them cluttering up. I'll just remove what I can. But we can't have them cluttering up. Oh yeah, that's another thing. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm remembering all of these things that we had as chores to do today. I actually want to update this chest. I realized it is so dumb of us to just be sitting here with a normal wooden chest. So we really need to upgrade this little chest from wood to iron. So let's see. Just need the little wooden chest, a little plank in the middle, surround it with iron, and then you can upgrade it, or to copper, huh? So we can upgrade straight to copper, and then copper goes to silver, and then silver goes to gold. Huh. I don't think I have silver, though. So let's just go wood to iron, and then iron to gold. So let's make some chest upgrades so we can put all of the plants that we possibly need. We're going to make it all the way up to into a diamond chest. That's another chore I've been meaning to do, Lily and Tate, and I've got to do it while I remember real fast. Meow! Always so much to do in the zoo. Okay. Nope, not raw ores. I want these guys. Gold. Iron. Let's see, I want some diamonds. That would be shiny gems. I don't remember how many I'll need. And then I need a piece of wood. Alright, then I'm going to come over here. I'm going to make the iron chest upgrade. There we go. Actually, I think I needed to do it differently, didn't I? All right. No, no, because you have to go each upgrade level. And then we have iron and we want to upgrade it to gold. So that would be this one. And then if we have gold and we want to upgrade it to diamond, then we need 1 gold, 2 diamond, and 6 glass. Oh, I love how that stuff doesn't pop out while we're trying to come over here and snag the materials we need. All right, good. Now I won't have that chest like filling up on me. I don't know why it didn't occur to me to do that sooner. There we go. So we'll upgrade that chest. Let's put our ingots and things away. In you go, guys. Put our shiny gems away. There we go. All right. There. That's another chore I've been meaning to do here in the zoo. Oh, sunrise. I love sunrise. Just think about it. We might be getting lots of little tweet-tweet twilight birds to add into our little separate bird aviary soon. That makes me so happy. All right, and then we're going to upgrade these puppies. This puppy right here. Oh, so exciting. All right, so we're going to do this one. Yay! And look, we've got this much room already. And then this one. Yay! Even more room. And then this one. Ba-doom! Oh, that's so overdue. I cannot believe that I haven't thought about doing that before. All right, now we can put away all of those guys and these mushrooms for now. There, that's much better. We could almost empty out the plant chest that are over by the reptile house and put them in here now. Good. We're going to leave it turned off for now, though, because we don't need it on for the moment. All right, let me think. Well, let's go. We're going to do this. I want to explore Twilight Forest. I think we have enough steel leaves because I'm in the mood, you know? Every now and then you just get in the mood for adventuring and exploring. And we haven't found those magic trees, and those are on the list. But we need to go up to Calf's house. And Mandy and a couple of you other amazing people who are always in our comments section down below pointed out to me that we should still have, unless Calf has raided them, some steel leaves in the chest. We should still have those steel leaves in the chest in Twilight Forest. So we're gonna go and check our little... you know what else we're gonna do? We just finished introducing quite a few. Yeah, I can hear them. We just finished introducing Pigman Watson's family down there. So I'm thinking that we might landscape as our next prank, because this is the thing people get to see when they come to my zoo, is Calf's pink acacia wood house. And I would love to landscape the front yard. So that might be our next prank. All right, I think the way... Oh, look, there's a zombie of all things. What on earth are you doing over here, sir? How odd. We never really have... There's more and more monsters lately. That's why we have to repair my armor. But I think it's just put plants in this sort of pattern and then throw a diamond in. And that starts the portal, if I remember correctly. So let's pop through and check what we left. Did Calf close it? Hello? I think Calf turned this off. What? This is just water. What? What? Okay. Well, let's go get a diamond. Oh, that's so funny. I thought something, I could hear the nether portal. That's what I could hear. All right, well, let's go get a diamond and we'll chuck it in and see if that activates it again, because my steel leaves are specifically tied to that portal, because we have a little base, a little cabin that Calf and I built on the other side of that portal. So I need those specific steel leaves to repair my armor. Look, it's gone down 20 durability this week alone. So it's making me a little bit nervous. I love my armor. Might need to check. I think I've got some more steel leaves in my house too. So we'll check on that in a second too. Hey, Lily, hey, Tate. Mom was trying to go to Twilight Forest and she ended up just jumping in a puddle and looking like a fool. Pretty darn sure. Look at the crab. He's moving around. That makes me happy. All right. Grab a couple of these. And then we climb past all of the vines and climb up. And then we'll go into the house to check how many steel leaves, just in case. I was hoping to pick up the ones we left in the cabin. But if we're having trouble, huh. All right, well, let's wiggle this way. Now we'll wiggle this way. There we go. So many things to close. I need more the little step pads. That's what I need. Pressure plates. All right, so. I am out of steel leaves. I must have used every last one of them. Okay, so there's actually no steel leaves waiting for us in here. There is a little bit of other armor, but I like my leaf armor. That's a big part of who I am. Leaves, obsessed with leaves and loving plants. All right, so we're gonna head down. We're gonna head back down and we'll throw this diamond in and see if that does anything. I feel so silly. I was just jumping around in water going, hello. Waiting to go to Twilight Forest. All right, at least we can empty these chests out now. That makes me happy. And build our little bee thing sometime soon and continue expanding our bamboo forest. There's just always, always endless projects here, which makes for awesome endless adventures, like when we just went to go gather up a whole bunch of the wetlands plants for the ducks, and we ended up rescuing some drowning ostriches and catching an enderman and all sorts of awesome adventures. All right, I think he turned it off. I don't remember why. All right. Let's see if this works. What? Whoa! Okay, there we go. Ouch. It's working again. Oh, gosh. There. Okay, good. Well, we're back on this side. And ouch. That smacked me pretty darn good. Let me drink a little bit of carrot juice to recover. Hello, Twilight Forest. It's been a while. How are you? All right, there we go. Let's fall. And then let's come in here. It's been a long time. I think it's free reign for whatever's in here. Oh, wow. There's a lot of milk in here. What the heck? Why is there so much milk? Oh, and there's a cool little book. Oh my gosh, look at all those steel leaves. There's extra steel leaf armor and stuff. That must have been part of Calf's split on our former adventures. Holy moly. Talk about some treasure. There's emeralds in here. Map mazes. Iron ingots. Maze wafers. Steel leaf sword with sharpness and knockback. And bane of anthropods and sets them on fire. It's a leaf sword that will set spiders on fire. That's awesome. What is that? Oh, it's a little skeleton. But oh my goodness. So there was actually a lot in here. Golden apple, lots of raw meef. There's a maze map focus, which is very useful if we find another maze. Blocks of quartz. Nice. Jeez Louise. What else is in here? I think this was my chest. You know, this pathetic little thing was my chest. And Calf had all this loot on him the whole time. And I had no idea. Well, let's take it home. I'm very happy to have this much milk too. And I still want to do some exploring, but in a new part of Twilight Forest. There's a little ram. There's another little ram. I want to do some exploring in a new part of Twilight Forest so that we can access some new areas, maybe find a magic ram. So we're going to set up a Twilight Forest portal at the Meadow of Horses. That's the plan. Whew, there we go. All right, now we're back home, and look, I have a little steel leaf pickaxe. I had no idea that he picked this thing up. Well, I'm gonna claim it for now. He can come and we can have a little conversation about it. Maybe a chocobo can be involved if he's sore about it. But I'm excited. I had no idea there was that much awesome loot hiding in there. I feel much, much better about the state of my armor and my gear now. I think my armor took another hit when that lightning hit me. That was wham! That really surprised me, actually. Hello, everybody. All right, now let's climb down. Let's see what to do. We've got so much cool stuff now. Lily Tate, Mom's back from Twilight Forest already, and boy, did I find some stuff. Whew, goodness. Let's come in here. I actually want to empty the milk buckets first, which seems weird, but there we go. I've actually needed milk, and being a milkmaid for a day is on the list of things that we plan on doing, believe it or not. All right. Into the cooler you go. And that gives us a whole bunch of new empty buckets to add to my bucket pile in there. So now what? Man, look at that. We've got extra helms and leggings and plate. My little booties are still at risk, but let's go heal them up. Let's go to our little armory section that we've got downstairs. Make sure everyone's doing okay. Professor Cowplant is properly studying the mushrooms. Got our chickens, good. Got our pigmen, our peaceful pigmen. We need to make him his little exploratory room soon too. So cool. All right, well, I'm gonna need to take my armor off so we can repair it. Yay, my leaves are safe. It means a lot to me. All right, and then, let's see. Oh, I'm gonna need more enchanting to be able to repair my stuff. And I just ate all of my essence berries, didn't I? Enchanting books. Oh my gosh, how embarrassing. All right, come here, essence berries. Oh my gosh, I really did. I just took out every stack and I was like, oh, I'm just gonna eat all these essence berries. And now look at where I am. almost not able to repair my own armor. How embarrassing. All right, well, we've got, honestly, like, I guess I could wait if I really had to repair some of this now that we have extras, because we have extra plate, we have extra helms, and we have extra leggings now. The steel-leaf helm is the one that's taken the most beatings. Yeah, we'll repair the helm. Nice! And then I could just put on the extra things. Boom! I want my old helm on. I knew which one it was. And then we can put the rest of this away! That's so cool! And we've got some awesome new weapons and some cool steel-leaf pickaxe. And I've got a new golden apple. We'll put this book away with Persephone. Nice! Well, that turned out a lot better than I thought it would. Sweet. And we got a ton of milk. I don't know where we got that milk from. I think it was samples we took from the minnow shroom, maybe? A little concerning there. All right, gonna come over to Persephone and put this book away. There we go. We're gonna go upstairs to my room. Collect more of the essence berries on our way there. Hello, Bella. I know, we're gonna learn how to do all sorts of potions soon. All right. Nom 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 nom. Essence berries. There we go. Collected the essence berries. We'll put those away. And then we've not really had any bad, dangerous adventures in Twilight Forest in a long time. I think this is going to be another cautious adventure with Sunflower. So I'm okay with taking our backpacks so that we've got stuff to put away. I'm okay with that in a new Twilight Forest area. I might regret that immediately, but I'm going to take that risk and we'll just see what happens. All right, so here we go. Let's put these steel leaves away. And then I have backup steel leaf armor. Never thought that would happen. That's kind of amazing. And then we've got these cool swords. I need this one. That's our sword of light. And then let's see, do I have... I actually have a lot of coins in my coin purse that I need to put away, or to put away in my coin purse from trading all those geishels. There we go. All right, coin purse, let's open you up. Yeah, that's because we used up, oops, I need that diamond. We used it all up, there we go, there we go. Good, good, good. Whew, what a day already. What a day. And we've got the diamonds that we need, the diamond that we're gonna need to make a new Twilight Forest portal. And we've got Sunflower with us. Gotta put Yogi away. And then the other thing I wanted to do, and I know this is gonna seem, well, let's take a nap. And I know this is going to seem totally random, is I want to plant some soybeans and tomatoes over in the Meadow of Horses. Mm-hmm. So we're going to at least transport the seeds over there. Ah, snooze time. And I hear a duck. Is there a duck in the back of my, like, tree area? I think there may be a duck. All right, well, let's go investigate this duck. Because if there's a duck behind my own house and I went all the way into that lush swamp searching for ducks, I'm gonna feel a little bit silly. Just a little bit. All right, let's come over here. Close, good, there we go. Oh, I need the seeds. Let's grab the seeds, search for the duck. Go to the village of the Meadow of Horses, and then we will head to Twilight Forest from there so that we're in an entirely different area, and hopefully we'll run into more of the absolutely amazing magic trees, because that's something I've been wanting to do for a long time. All right, so let me think. Oh, there's where my salt went. I feel so dumb. I was like, I'm out of salt, so I was so excited to find some. That is so silly, Artemis. So silly. Ugh, why am I inside? I shouldn't be inside. I need the seed shed. Oh, I love our world, though. I love our home. Our home is just so awesome. Bean seed, radish seed, coffee seed, peanut seed, beet seed. Was that soybean seed? Yes. We'll leave a couple, few, just in case. So got the soybeans, chili pepper, coffee, tomato. We'll leave a few just in case. We have not yet grown any tomatoes. And I feel like since it's autumn, more winter, I don't really want to grow them in our garden. So we'll grow them over in the Meadow of Horses. All right, now let's see if we can find this quack quack that I heard. All right, Mr. Quack Quack. Do we have a stray duck hiding around back here? Because I heard a quack. There is a duck behind our house. Oh my gosh. Come here, you. I have the perfect spot for you. Come here. Come here. Oh my goodness. Come here. Anybody else down here? Nope, just you. Well, now we can take the duck. We'll put Yogi away and the duck away. What a day. That honestly is like life though, isn't it? Where you just have one task after another and you're constantly moving, grooving, going, and look, it is a competitor for Bob's title. Look at that. Look at that sheep. Hang on. I gotta get up here so you guys can fully admire and appreciate just where this sheep is coming from. This sheep climbed up onto that little cliffside, across Cookie's magic tree, and all the way up into these big oak trees in the Berry Bakery yard. It's a competitor. This is truly a competitor for Bob's title as a tree climbing sheep, but he is going to be very sad when Bob is suddenly standing in sunflowers area, because that's, you can't, there's another duck. That's where our other duck got stuck. You ducks, come here. Come here, can I get you out? I think I can if I aim just right. Can I get you out of there, Mr. Duck? Seriously? Here, I'm going to take this away. There, and now maybe you won't get stuck. So there's two of our ducks. So that's where our other duck went, because I was like, oh no, I thought we lost a duck already. How's our fish spawning going? Not well, just one little fish, and it's having a lot of trouble. So we'll try to fix that later. All right, pop up here. I hear quacks. We need to name the quacks later so that we can make sure the ducks are being okay. Now let's go put Yogi away. He probably will escape again because he's cloned himself and escaped several times. But we will put Yogi away in his exhibit and try to keep him from escaping later. Good luck, Yogi. Try not to cause too much trouble. No, you can't come back out the way you got in. You gotta stay and admire your beautifully made, carefully cultivated exhibit, sir. He's like, rawr. Alright, so now we've got sunflower. What a day. And let's do this. We're going to go to the Meadow of Horses. Oh, I'm actually really excited. Hi, Willow Tree! I'm really excited because we might have the opportunity to find a magic tree. And I've been wanting to do that for a long time. And we will also collect ourselves up some more of the absolutely amazing birds. And we'll have a lot of birds to add to our temperate forest aviary. Also, check it out. It's a little decorative. Woo! A big lag spike from the mass hum that was suddenly in the village. But we've got a decorative little spot right here with the plants. I really like it. We're going to start trying to spruce the village up in more details like that too. So I'm pretty excited about that. Do-do-do. Let's go grab the teleportation stone. There you are, teleportation stone. All right, we're going to Meadow of Horses. Whew. What a busy day. What a busy day indeed. All right, and there's a scorpion over here. Probably not a safe thing to leave for the villagers. Let's see, Grandmother's Bakery. Scorpions? Yeah, sorry, dude. Just doesn't seem like something we can have where we want a Grandma's Bakery. Ducks! Are you kidding me? Ducks! Why did I not think of looking here for ducks? Come here, come here, get in here. No, you have no idea how hard I've been looking for ducks. Get in here. I heard a gobble gobble, but I don't want gobble gobbles. And there's a little garden snake. I want ducks. I didn't even think to look here for them. What? All right, here's the little farmhouse. Any more ducks? I feel so dumb. Of course there would be ducks here. This is like the farm area. Oh, are you doing okay, buddy? Oh, that nettle. Hang on, I'm helping. Got rid of it, don't worry. He'll stop being in pain in just a second. All right, and actually I was thinking, okay, that's a bunny. That's zombie plush, But I was thinking what we would do is kind of over by this willow tree is where I'm going to have... Oh, hello, little speckled snake. I heard a duck. Pretty sure I heard a duck. The ducks are going to drive me mad. I'm just going to be running around like, where's the duck? Ah, I'm so tired. I need some carrot juice now. Om nom 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 nom. Om nom 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 nom. There we go. Good healthy carrot juice keeps you going. Thought I heard another duck. But I was thinking over by this awesome willow tree is actually where I want to have my personal farmhouse. So this will be the area, I think, where we'll have some of my personal horses. This is a very special willow tree. And over here is probably where we'll have, like, the house and, like, ouch, nettle. Got you. Aha, more nettle. Got you. But I figure over here, like, would kind of be where... Oh, there's a cobra. Hi. Hi. I'm going to relocate you on the other side of the river, so you'll leave me alone. Ooh, some spleenwort. I love the maidenhair spleenwort ferns. All right, put you over here. Keep to yourself, and I'll leave you alone. But I was thinking, like, over here would be where I would want to set up my little part of, the like, a farmland. So this is where we will plant the tomatoes and the soybeans to grow. And we're just going to get them planted. We're not going to spend a lot of time. Don't worry. And then we're going to hurry. Let's see. Do this. Well, at least we got another duck, so I'll put that away. The chicken we need to release into the barn. We've got sunflower to do flying in Twilight Forest. It's a busy day, but it's organized, I swear. I swear it's organized. I've got it all in my head. Don't worry. Don't you guys worry. All right. So we're going to clear this little spot away, I think. Kind of flatten it out. There we go. Then I would really love to get some tomatoes. And see, we've got the buckets for putting water down. Good. Let's get a little bit of water. There we go. Got some buckets of water. Put the chicken away for now. I need the hoe. I've got some hoes. Brought them with me. There we go. Little wooden hoe. I know it seems totally random, but this actually, the smallest step, believe it or not, the smallest step in starting this helps me figure out where the heck we're going to have, like, the layout. Because this right now is just a giant field, and that's a little intimidating when you're, aha, more of the evil stinging nettle. And that's a little intimidating when you're trying to figure out how to, like, get things planted and get everything going. But when you can start breaking the field up by going, and here is where we've got some tomatoes, and here's where we've got some of the other stuff, it really helps. So back off, adorable pepper lookalike horse. This is where I'm gonna start. Then we'll put another water plot. Let's see. That's four away. We'll go ahead and put another one right here. And we'll figure out how to make this, like, nice and pretty later. Right now we're just getting things planted. So I can be like, oh, that's my back garden for my future spot. All right, tomato seeds over here, and soybean seeds over here. There we go. So let's start with the soybeans on the outside. There, and then I'll know, see, like, it makes such a difference just to have the one spot where you've got something started. And you can be like, aha, so that is the future location of this project. All right, we come out by three. We could go out by four. I think they'll still, like, they should still be moistened. There we go. Water little plots. There we go. Let's see, and let's put another one, another empty plot of water right here. Hopefully we won't be viciously attacked by something in a minute. A little bit worried about that too, but c'est la vie. Such is life. There you go. All right, that should be good. I guess we could put down some torches. That in Minecraft really goes, hey, I own this spot now. Back off. Back off, monsters. This is my future backyard garden with a beautiful river overview of a beautiful, currently, I thought you were a werewolf horse. I nearly took you out. I really did. This is currently a beautiful Arctic view of what will be our backyard. But one day, my friends, it will actually, we can terraform it if we want to. We'll decide if we want to terraform that area, what it would cost us in terraforming, and so on. And we've got some extra seeds, so why don't we just go ahead and the peanut seed, and a pea seed. Oh no! Stinging nettle! Hang on, horse! I'm coming! Get out of here, stinging nettle. There we go. And I think we're going to use a combination of blazing rods and grass for making the twilight portal. And I think we'll have the twilight portal right over here. Like, right from the backyard. Like, you walk down, they'll have a little staircase, and you can just walk straight into the twilight portal. So I think that's what we'll do. Put it right here. I hope I can set this up right. I think you just make the hole. Because calf set the last one up. Let me get more water in just a second. Then you make a little water spot. Come over here. There we go. Swap that out. One there. Just one more. Oh, it fixed itself. All right. So there's the water. Jeez Louise, I got a lot of these out for some reason. Let me put all this away. Good, 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 good. Put you away, put you away. Torches, you can stay with me just in case we're about to go to an aggressive area. Sunflowers with us. That chicken can just ride this out, this adventure out for now. Because I don't want to go all the way back to the barn at the moment. Then we're going to put the dotted blazing stars. Or I would if I could. There we go. Okay, I actually need a little bit more plants, please. I want more blazing stars and more grass. I don't know why, I just want that to be like my, when I think twilight, I guess I think those colors, you know? So I need more grass, actually. Because I'm pretty sure it can be any plant or foliage available in the game. There we go. There we go. All right, and now we add the final ingredient. Let's see if this works. Woohoo! I know! You gotta watch out, Mr. Horse! Alright, so let's do this! We've got a good start! We have planted tomatoes! We have planted soybeans! We have got a good established part over for where I'm going to claim my ground over here. We've got a pepper lookalike, and we've got a new Twilight Forest portal. Let's do this. Okay, we're through the portal. I grabbed this tree as soon as we popped out. And there's mushrooms already! It's cool! Already, it's absolutely awesome! Amazing big giant mushrooms! Oh, I'm so excited! Oh, and look, there's one of the little canopy trees! Oh my gosh, should we seriously like pop out right next? Ooh, and I got a firefly already? Okay, that's fine. Alright, Sunflower, you hang on, my darling. I'm gonna peek around a little bit. There's some cool water lilies. Oh, look at that! Wolves! I have not seen wild wolves yet! This is actually the first! Are you kidding me? We're gonna catch these wolves. This is the first time, you guys, that I have seen wild wolves at all since we moved to this world. At all. So we are going to go catch those guys. Oh my gosh, and that cute little pig. Wild wolf. Gotcha. Oh my gosh, a wolf exhibit. These are the first wolves I have seen. I thought I saw another one, but no. Just the deer. These two are the first wolves that I have seen since we have moved here. Seriously. Oh my gosh, look at that. That mushroom is growing in that tree. Oh, that's so cool. They were hungry wolves too. They just ate two whole sheep. Oh my gosh. Was that a bark? I'm like, Lily Tate? No, it's another wolf. All right, let's catch this one too. Got you. And got you. We've got a wolf pack, you guys. A wolf pack. Oh my gosh. That was an unexpected find. I did not expect to come into this getting a wolf pack. So that's pretty cool. Oh, I'm glad Sunflower was in our rucksack. All right, let's take these out. We've got to be prepared in case we see any little birds or any other cool things. Also, we need the steel shears just in case. Woo! And we are back. We are in Twilight Forest. We are in a whole new area. This is in a whole new spot. Far, far away from any of the other Twilight area that we have generated yet. So I'm really hoping... Oh, and we so need to mark where we're getting out is. I almost forgot to do that. I got so excited about everything. And all these giant mushrooms start looking the same after a while, so that could be very bad. See, I'm already having trouble locating, there we go, where we came from. So let's add portal home. There we go. There, much better. Now we know where to go to get back out. That's an essential part of Twilight Forest adventuring. But we are back. It has been a long, 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 long time since we've been to Twilight Forest. So I'm pretty excited just to take a minute's break to come over here for an afternoon. And look at these amazing giant mushrooms. I mean, look at all the little baby mushrooms that are growing under them too. Oh, mushroom canopy. It's a beautiful, glorious mushroom canopy. I love it. That's awesome. We might get on Sunflower in just a minute and see if we can start finding... ooh, there's a structure. Here's more of the pigs. They would be perfect for building that big safari exhibit. I'm thinking we'll take the safari zone and we will make it really big, like cover the entire barley fields. Ooh, random structure right here. Interesting. But I was thinking we could have it cover the entire barley fields and like have a jeep tour going through it with all the wild animals and things. Cicada. Ooh. I wonder if we'll get. I guess we should have gotten a map first so we could tell. But the hills are pretty obvious when you find the hills, or you find like any of these guys that actually have treasure and loot inside of them. I think it's time to get sunflower out, so we don't really need the torches. All right, darling. You ready? This is pretty exciting. We're in a whole new area. There's a lot of lava right there, so do be careful there. Moving. I know, the dweedwoo. Do you want to go straight up? Do you want to see if there's. Ooh, there's a giant ravine here, Sunflower. Let's actually check this out. She's going so slow today, but she really helps. That's because we're in a whole new area. All right, I'm peeking down the ravine, darling. Oh, well, that's helpful. Thank you. All right, and we are in a whole new place, so you'd assume if fossils show up in Twilight Forest, they would show up here. I don't see them. So someone told me, yeah, they show up. Oh, it's a torchberry plant. I need it, Sunflower. You know me and plants. Hang on. Right over here, darling. Right over here. There we go. But someone told me that they do. Hang on, darling. I'm gonna pop you in there. That fossils do spawn in Twilight Forest, but I don't know about that because they're not showing up here. And this is a brand new area, so if they were gonna show up anywhere, they would show up over here, you know? Wow, that could be painful death. There you go, you have a turnip seed. All right, come here. Come here, little torchberry. Gotcha. That makes me happy. All right, and then we will get our way out of here. And, oh, there's something. Hey, darling. Oh, there you are. Come on out. There is something that-a-way. Let's just run it since you're not feeling like flying. All right, so we found, jump over this. We found another one of these little, like, lich castle things. So I might as well mark this on the spot. And we can investigate it later. We could even convert it. Wouldn't it be cool to set up like a little medieval village around here with NPCs after we like defeat the evil king and get rid of him? From here, we could turn this whole thing into like a really cool little like medieval village that we could set up with everybody. That would be fun. All right, what's this area? Highlands, huh? Ooh, this is definitely one of those little hills that has like the mobs and has the treasure inside of it. And it's open too. All right, well, let's investigate this, Sunflower. Oh, I got an oak sapling too. Nice. No magic trees so far. But I'm pretty sure this is one of those little hills. So you go ahead and pop in here, darling. And I'm gonna go ahead and whip out. There we go. All right, let's see what this is. And I need, ooh, it's been a while since we've needed to use Moss Slugger. Come on out, Moss Slugger. Pretty sure this is one of those hills that has treasure and stuff inside of it, if you dig into the core. So we're gonna dig down into the core of this puppy a little bit. Found a patch of gravel at least. All right, let's get the torches there. There we go. It's like a mix of good old-fashioned Minecraft, excavating and mining. Oh wow, this makes it easy at least. Gravel, 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 gravel. But who knows if this is actually what I think it is. It looked like it on the surface, but maybe I need to go down from the top. Because sometimes it can be hard to dig properly into these little treasure hills. Maybe it wasn't a treasure hill. It sure looks like a treasure hill. So let's see. Anything here? Anybody here? Any treasure? Hello? Okay, nothing there. So let's climb back out. I'm gonna reevaluate the situation. It's a bird! Too much stuff already. Bird, got it. Yes, that's what we wanted. Nice little Twilight Forest birds. We've got wolves for the first time too. Well, I'll take a bird even if we didn't end up with a really cool, like, treasure. I swear this thing must have... Hang on, I'm gonna do something kind of silly. Gonna dig straight down, more or less. Kind of at an angle. It just looks so much like it would have something hiding in its little core. So much like treasure is just around the corner. And I just have to dig in the right spot to find it. Alright, we've already got too much stuff. So into the sack you go, all of you. Get out of here. I need room. Alright, go on. Shoo. Actually, Torch, you can come down here. Alright, Moss Slugger, I need you back out. Sunflower, you're gonna sit in the corner over there. I'm gonna keep that just in case we run across any mob. Even the hostile mobs, we can collect so we can take them to our hostile mob research that we're going to be doing. We're going to take that old stronghold and we are going to turn it into a hostile mob zoo area. So I'm pretty excited about that. Come on. Any goodies inside this little hill? Or were you... Aha! I found my own dig site. That's silly. I got so excited. I was like, found something. Nope. Maybe I'm not going deep enough, actually, because the hill continues on at this angle. Huh. Actually, maybe I need to come in from this side? Because it's actually a really big hill when you get down here. And that tells me it might have treasure. I'm not giving up. Not yet. Don't worry, I will try to keep this from being too dull. But come on, this could be more steel leaves. It could be more super rare treasure like that peacock fan that blows people away. There is a peacock fan in this area somewhere that blows people away, literally. And I would love to use that on Kafalooba. I think that would be hilarious. All right. What do you think, Moss Slugger? Is this a hill with anything in it? Give me your secrets! Nah, I think I would have, like, found... Well, there's some live root. Often that's, like, what's at the bottom, though. Because often the live root will be at the bottom of one of these spots. So hang on now. Let's harvest up this live root. There we go. Live root, are you telling me I'm digging too deep? Too deep. Or is it just hanging out here? Oh, it's teasing me! Because I keep thinking, oh, we must be onto something. Look, there's roots. But I think it's just teasing me. The live roots are useful to have, though. I think you can use them in something or another. Whoa, I thought I fell into a hole just then, and I was going to be like, no! Punch knuckles! Nope. All right, well, let's see. What happens if I use Moss Slugger on you? Anything good or bad? It just pops out like normal. Okay, then we're just going to use this one. Do, 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 do. The live root is useful, but this is not finding a magic tree, so I will resume task. I apologize, guys. Sometimes it's just so much fun to adventure. Our world holds the potential for so much exploration and adventure. We find pirate ships, mermaid grottos. We find abandoned ruins. We found that castle. I really would love to make, like, a medieval little village. Not just like Dragonhold Village, because Dragonhold's Village kind of specializes in dragons, but like a proper medieval village. Alright, I would say this hill has been somewhat excavated. Nothing has been found. We might come back with a treasure map and see if this is a hill that we can find anything in. In the future, there's another bird, a wee little bird. Caw! Is it a raven? Ooh, it is a raven! Nice! There we go! That makes me happy, because we need to have more of these birds, too. Add to our bird aviary. Nice. Good, good, good. All right, well, we'll get Sunflower back out and continue flying in just a second. There's a chicken. That always cracks me up. Chickens are everywhere, even in Twilight Forest. Whoa, deer! Jeez, you just showed up out of nowhere. You surprised me. All right, How's this looking? Looking pretty good. Looking pretty good. Not looking like any magic trees yet, though. So let's get sunflower out and continue our search. I know that they're supposed to be super rare, but geez Louise, sunflower. This rare? This rare, my dear? Do you feel like flying now? Yeah, a little bit. She's feeling a little bit better about flying. There's another structure. Oh, here's another castle. Hello, second castle. They're like within sight of each other. Wouldn't it be fun to fill up the entire area between these two castles with like ruins? I think that would be really cool. Or not ruins, with like the magic medieval city. Oh, there was something going on over here. Oh, hey, it's another one of these fire portal things. Actually, we do have... Oh, look at that. That's so cool the way it changes colors. We do actually have a silk touch now. So I wonder if I could pick up some of those fire thingies with a silk touch. That would be kind of cool. To get the way that the fire just continually boils and rumbles for something. And there's a ravine over here too. Careful, darling. This place actually spurts fire at you, so I don't want you to get caught in that. There's lava. See? Oh, is this a Hydra's home? It sure is a Hydra. It's a fire Hydra's home. How cool is that? What's it blocking? A little bit of glowstone at the back. Wow. Oh, and it's got a perfect observatory right up here to see the fire Hydra. Just gonna perch right here. Nice! Oh, and I can hear the little spawner up here too. So you can see the fire hydra and you can see like the castle in the distance. That's pretty cool. All right, well, let's see what else is there. This is a quest for magic trees. We did a bazillion and a half tasks today. Oh my gosh, is this seriously another castle? Dang. We'll have to do something with all these castles. It's just begging to have something done with it. What's that? Oh, it's that weird beacon thing that happens sometimes. Are we done, Sunflower? She's like, oh my gosh, so much new land. Let's see, more Twilight Forest. I just want a magic tree. I'll admit, I'm greedy. I don't want just one. I want a whole bunch of them. Ah, but still no sight of magic tree. Here's a few more of the big old trees, though. And then here's one of these areas, the Dark Forest. Apparently there's squirrels in Twilight Forest. I've yet to find any squirrels. See, there's you. Sunflower, we might just have to contain attempting to find the magic trees to being only during like side quests. Because we're just not having any luck. We end up spending the whole day just kind of puttering around. There's some ruins. It almost feels like I've looped back because this place looks so similar to the other way to get home. Oh, here's a labyrinth. How's it looking? It's looking pretty broken. I don't want to go down there and get attacked by some minotaurs though. So we'll come back to that. Short trees. We'll give it a little bit more adventure. At least we get, oddly enough, at least we can be really happy that we got the tomatoes planted. Is this another labyrinth? And we have more labyrinths, and they're actually pretty fun to explore. So yeah, did we do, darling? Hang on. I'm gonna put this down, add mazes over here. And that'll be like someplace we can come. And we can try getting in the labyrinth on side quests and things when we just want to have a little bit of fun. So much new land. Oh my gosh. Oh, it's another Hydra. Well, let's flap our way this way, Sunflower, away from that Hydra. And we'll kind of circle back around to the entrance. Beautiful, beautiful fungi forest. I love these fungi forests. They're just so lovely. I wish we could get some trees like this up where our mushroom island is. Whoops. Sorry, Sunflower. Ouch, sorry, sunflower. Oh, let's get up and out of the ouchy fungus. I didn't think hitting a wall of fungi would hurt that much, but apparently it leaves a bit of a mark. All right, this is definitely one of those treasure hills. One way or another, this is certainly a treasure hill. So I'm gonna add this, and we'll come back to these points. Treasure hill in the future. We'll leave it on for now so we can, oh, thank you, sunflower. She's trying to cheer me up. Even though we don't have any of the awesome magic trees still, despite combing over the forest for it so carefully. Here's another castle. Maybe I'll just like, look, I'll leave you alone. I won't kill you, evil monster magic king, if you will give me a single magic oak tree. Did we know? Still no luck, huh? Oh, got some more structures. Oh, we've got something over here. Hey, I think this is like a Naga's place. Yeah, check out the Naga. I wonder if we can contain that thing. Oh, it's so cool, it's a giant snake. Sunflower's like, I don't want to, Mom. Did you hear that? Like, did we do? She's like, uh-uh. All right, we won't go there, Sunflower. Maybe that means we'll get lucky and find some labyrinths soon, though. Let's see. Exploring and adventuring. Oh. Here's a maze. That's boding a little bit better. Let's see, because sometimes there's decent treasure in here. Ooh, and actually that does spawn wolves. Does that spawn ravens? Is that a bunch of ravens that spawned in? That's awesome. So there's actually like this little maze area. Sunflower, can you land on these without getting hurt? Nope. Oh my gosh, those really hurt her. I'm sorry, darling. Mama didn't mean it. I'm so sorry. I know, I'm sorry. Well, I'll explore this labyrinth on my own later, where it's not risky for you to get hurt. Because I don't want her to get hurt either. Okay, one second. Let's land and catch our breath for just a moment. And then... aww. I'm trying not to get discouraged, but I really want the magic tree. And we found a lot of other cool stuff. But while it's really cool and it's awesome to have so many castles and so many hills and Naga and Hydras to fight, I just want a shiny rainbow oak. I just want a rainbow oak. Is that too much to ask for? I do think I have some Geishal greens. In fact, look, Sunflower, there's some Geishal greens down here. Let's land and heal you up. Since Mom just made you land on the freaking ouchy hedge. So let's heal Sunflower up really quickly. All right, there you go, darling. That better? Is that all better? I think that helped her out. She's like, da-dwee-dwoo. Yeah, that helped her out. Ah. Oh, here's another one of the hills. So at least we've got another awesome place to come with a floating little doodad. And I guess we can collect a ton of moss. So we'll do these for some side quest. Add this, another treasure hill. There we go. So we've got multiple treasure hill waypoints now. So we can come back and investigate for more treasure, more moss too. There's probably a ton of moss to gather here.
Did we do, darling? Did we do? And any last minute discoveries of any?
Well, there's that thing. There's another one of those forests. They go on and on and on and on. You can't see anything, those dark forests, because you have to go inside them. We've never actually looked in one of those, so maybe we'll go in there sometime. Oh, here's another hill. Probably another treasure hill. All right, let's mark this one too. Add treasure hill, question mark. Okay, there we go.
Did we through?
And we'll do a tiny bit more exploring. Just a tiny bit. On our way to the portal home, we'll cross across this endless sea of plant. I mean, it's kind of amazing. Oh, did that hang on. Look, you can see under it. There's something under it. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. So we can see that there's like some sort of portal or some sort of structure under here on the map. That is so cool. So we'll definitely have to explore in there at some point. I see a lot of mushrooms. We could collect mushrooms one day. Just kind of come and collect an endless amount of mushrooms. Here's another labyrinth. So plenty of labyrinths. I would give so much for just one sheep. One sheep with the rainbow oaks. One sheep. It truly is. Ugh, you know what? That's okay. This is okay because even though it sucks that we still don't have a single rainbow oak under our belt, and we have traveled so far and looked so wide. Here's some more animals. Any little birds? Oh, hey, there's some moss. Moss cheers me up. This cheers me up at least. A teensy bit of the green gold here. So at least this is cheerful. There we go. All right, let me check if there's any inside sunflower. There is. Oh, that's a good haul, actually. So there's a good haul of at least the green gold. All right, and then let's throw a bunch of this stuff in here. That's right, get in there. There we go. Jump back on my awesome sunflower. Put this away. There we go. We still haven't seen any more little birds either, but we've been up, up, up. I know! We only need the little birds for the temperate bird forest aviary. Don't take it too personally, Sunflower. You're my best big bird. Yeah, you are. Alright, I think that's all she wrote. More labyrinths. More awesome trees. More of so many things. Oh, what's this? Oh, glowstone hanging in the trees. Uh-huh. Is that just teasing me? Is that just to tease me? Big ocean. More glowstone hanging in the trees. I haven't seen that happen too much before. It's very pretty, though. I actually really, really, really like the way it looks. Let's see. Let's turn the waypoints off for a second. Because that's very lovely, actually. I wonder what that means. It feels like whenever you see stuff like that, it feels like someone's been here. You know that's not true, but still. But still, Sunflower. All right. Whoops. There we go. All right, you guys. I think this is it. I'm going to fly back to the portal with Sunflower. And we've generated quite a bit. Oh, here's another treasure hill. Let's mark this. These are where we find our steel leaves, inside of here and inside of the treasure hill. Inside of the labyrinths. So let's turn on the portal home. But yeah, I'm going to fly back to the portal home and we will get home to Zoodesia and we will, I promise, resume zookeeping duties and building more exhibits. Like I said, I'm thinking panda is up next. We've got some fun things to work on with the pandas. Ooh, another treasure hill. Nice. There's quite a few of them here. But I really wanted to give it a go. I really wanted to check that awesome thing off of our checklist at having a magic tree. Woo. Delaggity lag. And unfortunately, we still don't have a magic tree, but that's okay. Holy days. Is this another hydra? Nope, it's another one of the magic hill, or the big hills. Because they always start sparkling like this because we have too many items on. So I'm going to mark this one for sure. Huge treasure hill. For sure. Whoops. There we go. Alright, but yeah, I'm going to work our way home. And if I find the awesome magic oak trees on my way home with Sunflower, then I will bring you guys back. But if not, then well, guys, I will see you guys bright and early in the morning. We did a bunch of random things today, and I promise tomorrow we will celebrate our attempts at trying to find the awesomeness of the magic oak tree by opening up some of the amazing fossils we have with our paleontology picks. And thank you guys so much for sticking with me on another amazing, super awesome Saturday special. We've got repaired armor. We've got all sorts of awesome things going on. We just don't have any magic oaks, and that's okay. We'll get back to zookeeping, and we will get back to working on our panda exhibit and our other awesome exhibits and seeing if we can get more amazing terror birds tomorrow. So I'll see you guys then. Bye-bye. Huh. Well, it's definitely not a rainbow oak tree, but that is pretty darn cool. We just might do something and turn this into a really cool... We'll remember this is here, Sunflower. We will remember this is here indeed. Holy freaking days! No way! Sunflower, land! 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 I was gonna give up! I was getting discouraged! I was sad! I was disappointed! Where are we? Oh my gosh. We're in an enchanted forest. What? 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 Oh my gosh. 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 Okay. Okay, don't panic. These trees are changing color. But are they rainbow oak trees? Where's my shears? I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous right now. Shears? Shears, what do you say they are? You say they're just rainbow oak leaves. Rainbow oak leaves. Rainbow oak leaves! This is a rainbow oak. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, how many are there? I think that's a rainbow oak too. Oh my gosh. Okay, we're gonna punch it to death. I know that seems weird, but you can get more saplings through punching, can't you? Sapling, sapling. Voiceless excitement! I can't even words, look at it! You guys! I was so sad because I was like, oh my goodness, you know. Oh, it's the end of the adventure. Oh, Seri, you weren't cheerful enough for everybody this time. What are you doing, Seri? And look at what I have in my hand. Ah, yes! What an awesome day. This is so awesome. Well, you guys, check this out. We have our rainbow oak saplings. We found the enchanted forest on our way home. I could not be happier. Holy days. Enchanted forest. Let's make this a fun color. A really fun color. Why don't we make it like... Yeah, there we go. There we go. Oh my goodness. Ah, waypoint here in my face. Wow. Wow. After all that stress and all of that sadness, because we couldn't find these trees. Well, we need to make sure we get plenty of... There's saplings. Oh, there's two. Oh my gosh, I have two rainbow oak saplings in my hands right now. Oh, I'm so happy. I feel like we need to give one to Junior and JJ when we reformat their, like, redo their houses. I feel like we need to give, oh, there's a third one. Yes. I feel like we need to give Junior and JJ some rainbow oak saplings. What a long special. I'm so sorry, guys, but I was like, oh my gosh, no way. Is that seriously what I think it is? When we were flying back to the portal, I had really given up. I was feeling discouraged. Like, maybe they just never show up. Maybe it's just a joke. Twilight oak wood turned into normal oak wood planks. Saplings! Let's get this one too. Oh, and then I just like, I want to like carry them safely in my arms all the way back to Zoodesia. Oh joy, we planted tomatoes, we repaired our still leaf armor, and we've got some awesome rainbow oak saplings. I feel fulfilled. I needed that sense of like, yes, we have found a rare treasure. And we have found a rare treasure. We'll have to put one in our memorial garden area for sure. And we're definitely, I just feel like we need to give Junior and JJ one because they're awesome. They're our sons. I love them. All right, let's clean this up. Five rainbow oak saplings. Oh, and a color changing forest. Oh my gosh. Yeah, there's not a lot of these. I think that this is like, is this another huge one? Like it's a conglomerate of a whole bunch of different trees, it looks like. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Well, I'm not going to cut that one down because that's beautiful. Look, it's doing it again. It's doing it again. Oh, that's so freaking beautiful. That's so awesome. Oh, and I'm so worn out because we have been hunting and hunting and searching for exactly this. I need more pictures. More pictures in the amazing oak forest. Portal home, you are in the way. There we go. Oh, see, I am so worn out because we adventured so much to get here. I'm so tired. That's why it's important, you guys, even when it's an amazing thing like finally finding an enchanted oak forest where you can collect these rare. I've already got a handful, so I don't want to cut these down in case these don't work. We need to come back to get more. But that is why. Oh my goodness, look at this one. Oh, it's beautiful. That is why, you guys, like, sometimes it's more about paying attention to the journey and the process than actually where you end up. Because I was getting so sad and discouraged, and I should have just enjoyed the journey more because we got there eventually. Oh, I'm so happy. Okay, well, let's climb up. Let's see how far this forest goes. Usually the quest ram is like around the enchanted forest, I think. But I'm not seeing him. Oh, and there's so many of these trees. Oh my gosh, we found rainbow oak saplings. That was really something I thought would never happen. I think I see the quest ram's place. I think I see it on the map. Did we find Mr. Quest Ram? Oh goodness. We found him. We found him. He is glorious. He is amazing. He is fantastic. So are these trees. Okay, well, this is gonna be a very special... This will be, like, a very special future... Okay, quest ram. We've discovered him. That was today's quest, was just finding him. Finding his beautiful grove with these amazing rainbow oak saplings. We have accomplished this. We have finally done it. And now we're gonna go home. And we will come back another day, and I'm gonna catch that little bird. I'm so gonna catch that little bird. I don't think we can put him inside the safari nets, so we're gonna leave him there for now. That's a chicken. I hear you. I hear you. I just don't. Ha! Oh, oh, oh. Nope. Gonna catch it. 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 Oh, he's teasing me! What a cute. It's like a little canary or a robin. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Oh. Oh, what a tease. Oh. Got him. Sweet. Woo! But there we go, everyone! Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry I sound so tired. We've been going at it and going at it, exploring, adventuring. It has worn me out, but I'm so happy. I mean, look at this. How can you not be happy in a land of color-changing ferns and absolutely beautiful oak trees? It's just... I mean, look at this. How could you not find this truly enchanting? Oh. Well, we have found it, my friends. We have found it, and we will be back. And here's another crow. Gotcha. Ooh. Ooh. I thought I heard a baby bird. Oh, I want the red bird more than I want the crow at the moment. Got it. And we've got ourselves some tiny birds to help out. Let's see. Do I have any more empty safari nets? I do. Got you. Oh my gosh. What a nutty day. I'm so tired. I'm so exhausted from this huge adventure. Gonna go re-catch that crow. Come here. Come here. Come here. Almost. Gotcha. Alright, and I heard another little bird. Tweet again, my little one. Oh, I think we're closing in on him. Hello? Hello, little bird. Well, all right, that is enough for today, my friends. I am so exhausted. I feel like I could just fall asleep under these trees, and I just might. So I will see you tomorrow. Like I said, we'll sort out our treasures from this amazing expedition. We will get our tree planted. We might work on Junior and JJ's place. I definitely want to get back to work on some of the animal exhibits. So we will work on some of that tomorrow. And now, on a much happier note, I can say, see you guys then.